Stellarium is free planetarium software that can be downloaded from www.stellarium.org. When we first open Stellarium, up in the upper left-hand corner, we see we're running Stellarium version 0.11.3. Down in the bottom, we see that we're on Earth in Paris. The 38M is our altitude. We've got our field of view of 60. The FPS is frames per second, or how much the screen is being updated. Then we have our date and time, July 4th, 2012 at 8:11 a.m. We don't see any stars right now because it's still daylight in France for this time of day. The time showing is from my computer. It looks like it's a nice day there in France, but this is not an actual camera view in France. We'll see that same field in other locations as well. If I move my arrow to the bottom of the screen, we see a horizontal pop-up menu. If I move it to the left, we see a vertical pop-up menu. This top icon says location window F6. Clicking that opens up our location window. Hitting F6 toggles it on and off. To change the location, we can scroll through the locations and just click on one. We can see here in China, it's the middle of the night. I can also just click on the map. In Australia, it's the middle of the night. And in the US, in the Eastern Standard Time Zone, back where I'm at, it's the middle of the day. I want to create a location. Since I live in the Eastern Standard Time Zone of the US, I'm going to click in there. And I'm going to use my altitude of 30 meters is good. I'm not in China anymore. I want to change that to the US. And I want to give my location a name. So when I create this Frugal Computer Guide location, it'll be in the US. I'll be at this longitude, latitude, and this altitude. I'd like to make this my default location. So every time I start Stellarium, it will start me at my Frugal Computer Guide location. I need to add this to the list. And there we have it. It's still daylight here, that's why I can't see any stars, but at least I'm in the right location for my time. Now we want to change the time so that we can see some stars. This next icon down has date and time window, F5. I mean, I can click this icon or hit F5 to bring up the date and time window. It's 8 a.m. The default is a 24-hour clock. So I want to make it about 10 p.m. So I need to go 10 hours after noon. So I do 10 plus 12, 22. Now it's 10:30 p.m. This is what I would see outside of my house if I look to the south. To look in the other directions, I'm going to use my arrow keys. I'm going to the right, hitting the right arrow. Now I'm looking to the west. Now I'm looking to the north. Now I'm going to hit my left arrow. That takes me around back to the south. I can also hit the up arrow and the down arrow. If I want to know more about a star or planet, I can just left click on it. And information comes up in the upper left hand corner. Let's take a look at Saturn. If I hit my space bar, it brings it to the center of the screen. To zoom in on this, I can use page up. And I'm zooming into Saturn. And page down takes me back out. We'll also notice that our field of view changed. We're now at 55. If I zoom in again, if we look at that field of view, we see that those numbers are going smaller and smaller. We're down to 0.027 and then back out. If we use our forward slash and backslash, our forward slash zooms us in. The backslash zooms us back out to 60 degrees. To get rid of the information on the screen, I just right-click. Putting our arrow over the horizontal menu bar, if I go down to this lower corner, there's a little triangle. If I click on that, it becomes a square. Now when I move my arrow away from the menu bar, it stays in place. Taking a look at it, we see some are white and some are gray. If they're gray, they're turned off. If they're white, they're turned on. To turn on the constellations, we come down to these lines and we see constellation, or we can type in the letter C, we'll turn on the constellations. Now to know which ones we're looking at, we want to see the constellation names. And that can be done with V or our next icon. And those are pretty good. And at this point, we can still use our arrows to look around the screen and the zoom in and zoom out. But some of these constellations, like this line here, are kind of difficult to know what that is. So what the people at Stellarium did is they created some artwork. And let's turn that on either by clicking the letter R or this icon. So we can now see the constellation that this line represents. Now to minimize this menu, let's turn this square back into a triangle. So if I look out to the west tonight, these are the constellations I can see.